Mr. Boplana, thank you for this interview.
No, thank you for having me.
We know that tennis has a long tradition in India, and please, can you tell me how much is tennis popular in India?
I think tennis is definitely the top three sports in India. Mm-hmm. It is, like you mentioned, it has always been popular. We've had a good tradition, mm-hmm. for tennis for a number of years. And there are, in every city, there's a lot of interest for tennis, and tennis is growing. And I think it's such a big country that, there's great potential for India. And I think, one of the main reasons I decided to also start a tennis academy in India.
Mm-hmm. And we see huge investments in China in tennis, and India is second most populated country. Are there some investments in India too? And maybe do you plan to bring some kids from India sometimes in Serbia or from Serbia in India?
I think the government right now is definitely helping a lot of sportsmen. They are recognizing the talent India has and really giving them good support. Of course, one of the main reasons when I started Rohan Bopanna Tennis Academy and also getting good Serbian coaches to the academy, mm-hmm. was not only for the coaches to come there and help the kids, but eventually maybe have some kids come to Serbia also, because Serbia has a great tradition for great tennis players, and mainly the work ethics and everything, which is what is required in India, which I felt we needed to see what in Europe, how the training methods were, how the standards were,
and tournaments are different.
It's a great base to have in Europe. Serbia will be a great base, because there are tons and tons of tournaments in Europe compared to in India. We still need to get a lot more tournaments in India in order to make better players, and I think a good structure is in place. So that's what I've been planning in Bangalore, to have a good structure, to have coaches from Serbia especially, to adapt Indian coaches together and work out a good system.
You mentioned these Serbian coaches. Are you satisfied with collaboration with them? What are your experiences in work with Serbian coaches?
No, I met
Dragan Bukumirović is a coaching mentor of your academy.
Yes, mm-hmm. I met Dragan a couple of years back in Miami, and after that it's been a year and a half since we've collaborated. It's not only Dragan, Igor, Marco and Dejan, there are four coaches who keep coming in and out in Bangalore. Mm-hmm. I think it has made a big difference in terms of getting discipline for the players, mm-hmm. and also for the players to understand, for them to become better and get to the highest level, how much work needs to put in. Mm-hmm. I feel that coaches from here have seen these players, have worked with players, so that's what I was trying to bring in. We've really had a good collaboration for a year and a half now, and I'm really enjoying them being in India. Of course, I know more than me having them, for them coming to Bangalore and adjusting obviously would took a while, but I think now they're very familiar with Bangalore, and I'm really happy that the collaboration with world-class tennis is going fantastically well.
Mm-hmm. You mentioned you started your academy, established one and a half year, and are you satisfied with how much kids and parents in India are coming into tennis? And please tell me about your ambitions with your academy.
I think it's just probably 20% right now what the kids and parents are coming. I think there is so much more to grow in India.
Yes, right, big now, big numbers.
Yeah, right now we just got a very a good academy in the center of Bangalore. So the structure is slowly getting into place. Mm-hmm. It's been about 7-8 months. With all of us coming together,
it
needs time, and I think it's a system we're trying to build and mm-hmm. eventually get to a proper structured system where a lot more kids can come out of it. Right now we have a lot of advanced training, about 20-25 advanced kids who are training there, who are now understanding what real kind of work is needed for becoming a tennis player. Mm-hmm. You know, and that comes with the help of all the coaches coming in, and you know, who have seen top players who have trained in the country, mm-hmm. to adapt, you know, to India, to make them understand what really is required. You know, I feel that that's what we lack. Even me, as when I was growing up, we didn't have that kind of structure. It took a long time before myself understanding what is required and how much is required, and the discipline. I, you know, in India, a lot of, including myself, I mean, I started tennis players, we are very lazy, mm-hmm. so, you know, so mm-hmm. that has to make a difference. And I think, you know, having Marco, Igor, Dragan, anybody there to bring in that discipline, to make sure everybody's on time, working hard, mm-hmm. I think is making the change. And I know it will make a difference in the coming few years.
Yes. You are famous doubles player. You were third in the world. We in Serbia don't have much success in doubles, except Nenad Zimonjić, of course. But please, can you suggest for our readers, young readers, why they should play doubles? Why it is important, and why do you like playing in doubles?
It's very funny, you know, in India they ask me the question, why we don't have singles players? You know, here you're asking me why we don't have doubles players. So, you know, but in a way, that's why maybe I'm getting Serbian coaches to improve our singles. Mm-hmm. Maybe we should get Indian coaches.
Yeah. And Serbia with doubles you don't have problems.
No, yes. But I think doubles really helps any player to improve their volleys, improve their returns. Consistency on the returns, especially as a young age, for you, not only, you know, once you make it later in your career, but at a young age to practice a lot of doubles, play a lot of doubles matches, because that really helps you bring in the target and focus on targets. And you know, especially nowadays, a lot of the kids don't like to come to the net, they prefer mm-hmm. to stay in the baseline. So I think that also automatically improves your volleys.
Yes.
And you know, volley is such a huge part of the game. If you see any top player today, they are extremely good from the baseline, but they're very good at the net when they come to the net as well. Mm-hmm. And you know, I think that transition is where you know, a lot of players have to improve. And so right now, you know, the balance between that is yet to be worked on. But you know, I think in India, you know, we slowly headed in terms of, you know, discipline and structure, and hopefully, you know, both will come into place.
And singles and doubles to be successful.
Absolutely. Successful. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I want to ask you questions about this Davis Cup match. I wish you success, of course, but I will cheer for Serbia. I wish you good luck on Sunday in Kraljevo.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank Very you. Happy to be in you know, Serbia again. It's my third
time. I forgot to ask.
I came to Novi Sad for Davis Cup in 2011. Then my wife and me came on holiday for 3 days. Now I'm back here for Davis Cup. So
Please tell me your impressions about Serbia.
I mean, you know, I love the country. It is, you know, extremely, extremely beautiful, and you know, most importantly, everybody is very friendly. You know, I think obviously makes a big difference, and when you get warm hospitality from people, you know, you automatically like the country.
And where you were on vacation here?
In Belgrade.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah, so I was in Belgrade, and you know, I'm really happy to be back. But thank you so much.
Thank you, and good luck.
Thanks a lot.